Gonzalez and the veteran Daniel Ponce de Leon. Between them, Gonzalez and de Leon have 80 knockouts, and many of them have been of the spectacular one-punch variety. Daniel Ponce de Leon coming off a 10-round unanimous decision victory against left-handed Eduardo Lascano. And that was in May of this year, a former WBO junior featherweight champion who tonight will be challenging Gonzalez for the 126-pound championship.
And he and his manager, Frank Espinosa, right behind him, have said that they feel like they've been chasing Johnny Gonzalez for a while. Gonzalez, for his part, says, no, it was just that when I was with Golden Boy, they couldn't make the fight. We were in different weight classes. But Ponce de Leon has the mental outlook that Gonzalez doesn't want to fight him, and he seems energized over that.
Yeah, whatever psychological advantage you can give yourself, right?
The champion, Johnny Gonzalez, turning 31 today, and for the third consecutive year, fighting on Mexican Independence Day weekend. He has won 12 fights in a row, 11 by way of knockout, coming off a 12-round unanimous decision win against former WBC featherweight world champion Elio Rojas. And Paulie, we've got a birthday boy sitting with us here tonight, Al Bernstein. Happy B-Day, big guy.
Thank you, I
birthday, big guy.
I'm a little older than Johnny Gonzalez, just a little.
Just a little, but you can't even tell.
Here's the tale of the tape for this WBC featherweight championship bout.
Now, in this case, unlike the last fight, the man with the height and reach advantage, which is Johnny Gonzalez, would like to use that. Even if he's a power puncher, which he is, he likes to do it from a distance.
Let's go to Jimmy Lennon Jr. for the official introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, Nevada, our hard-hitting action continues in Knockout Kings with our next attraction coming your way, a world championship bout brought to you by Golden Boy Promotions and Showtime. We are sponsored by Corona Extra La Cerveza Más Fina, DeWalt Tools and their new 20-volt Max Brushless technology. They are guaranteed tough. AT&T, the nation's largest 4G network. AT&T, rethink possible. And O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices every day. This bout is presented in conjunction with Del Pueblo Promotions and is sanctioned by the WBC President Jose Suleiman, Supervisor Rex Ross Walker. Introducing to you our three judges scoring from ringside. From Las Vegas, Nevada, Dick Houck. Also from Las Vegas, Jerry Roth. And from Tulsa, Oklahoma, David Sutherland. Introducing to you our third man in the ring. He'll be giving instructions after the introductions, Kenny Bayless. All right, fans, here we go. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBC Featherweight Championship of the World. Introducing to you first the challenger on my right, fighting out of the red corner, wearing black trunks with green and red trim, fighting out of West Covina, California, by way of Cuauhtemoc, Chihuahua, Mexico. He weighed in at 125 and one half pounds with a record of 43 wins and 4 losses. He has 35 wins coming by way of knockout. Currently ranked the WBC number 6 contender. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the longtime former WBO junior featherweight champion of the world, introducing Daniel Ponce de Leon. And his opponent across the ring, the defending world champion, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black trunks with silver trim, hailing from Mexico City, La Ciudad de Mexico, Distrito Federal, Mexico. He weighed in at a ready 125 pounds with an outstanding record of 52 wins and 7 losses. He has 45 big wins coming by way of knockout. And tonight he is making the 5th defense of his title. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the 2-time world champion and the current WBC featherweight champion of the world, introducing Johnny Gonzalez. And once again, a referee in charge now to give instructions, Kenny Bayless.
Okay, gentlemen, trunks are good on both sides. Gentlemen, I went over the rules in the dressing room. I want you to keep this fight clean at all times, protect yourself at all times, and what I say, you must obey. Good luck to both of you, Bruno Suarte. Touch him up.
Don't forget, after the main event, we will determine who is the knockout king of the night. The fans at home and here in the arena will vote via text messaging after the main event and choose the best KO. So far, 2-for-2. And the winner of this voting will be crowned knockout king and be awarded an extra $100,000.
Tell you, when I first saw the card, I thought this could be the knockout of the night fight. They both get a lot of knockouts and they both get knocked out.
And we are set for the first of what could be 12 rounds for the WBC Featherweight Championship. The champion, Johnny Gonzalez, having won 12 in a row, 11 of those via form of knockout. The challenger, Daniel Ponce de Leon, coming forward early. Gonzalez in the black with silver trunks. Ponce de Leon in the black with green. And Ponce de Leon spent time training at the same gym as Jesus Soto Caras. The Sky High Gym in Big Bear, California, getting some of that high altitude training in to help with his conditioning. Overhand left by the challenger.
Ponce de Leon, of course, as you see, a left-hander trying to land the straight left. Well, Toshiaki Nishioka, the Japanese champion, knocked out Johnny Gonzalez back in 2009 with a straight left hand. And it was at that point that Gonzalez got with Nacho Beristain. He was thinking his career might be over. Since then, he's been undefeated, and he has fought at a different level.
Hooking up with the Hall of Fame, a trainer inducted in 2011. Of course, our broadcast partner, Al Bernstein, inducted this year. And Beristain thinks that eventually Gonzalez could move up to 130 pounds. But first thing is first, he wants to successfully defend his 126-pound title here tonight.
Well, he does have a big frame. You see the difference in size here from De Leon. De Leon, the thicker guy, but definitely Gonzalez has a frame that could fill out to a bigger weight.
Nice jab a moment ago by Gonzalez. It's a weapon sometimes people forget to use against left-handers. Gonzalez also has a very good left hook to the body, and he has scored a couple of knockouts with that punch, and he wants very much to land that as well.
Final minute of the opening round. A relatively cautious start compared to the action we've seen here so far tonight at the MGM Grand, giving all of us a bit of a respite.
Hey, we needed a rest, didn't we, for a second? Catch our breath.
Hey, but don't catch your breath too long, because these two guys, just as slow as they're going right now, they can pick up the pace real quick.
Absolutely, and Ponce de Leon so far trying to land what is almost like a catapult-like left hand, the southpaw. And now Gonzalez putting together a three-punch combination. Final 5 seconds of the opening round for the WBC Featherweight Championship.
The keys for Johnny Gonzalez: move to his left, not his right. He's done that, and he has controlled the pace, I think, very well, and just started to get that right hand toward the end of the round. As for Daniel Ponce de Leon, shouldn't lunge, but guess what? He did that a lot in round one, and if he keeps doing it, he's going to get hit with a counterpunch. Has not been able to work the body as much as he'd like. Did land a couple of left hands. That's the punch that, if it was a knockout, that'll be it for him.
Luminaries in attendance tonight, including Mark Anthony. Huge boxing fan.
Won't find a better vocalist anywhere than him.
Round two underway, and it's been in the second round where Johnny Gonzalez has recorded 14 of his 45 victories via KO for Ponce de Leon. The second round has produced 5 knockouts.
Johnny Gonzalez had 8 of his 10 connects in the last round in the final minute. So it took him a couple minutes to kind of control the pace, and that's when he started to do his best work.
Yeah, he's boxing intelligently, just trying to feel out the distance. He's coming in, he's coming out. I think as he gains his distance, he'll start to shoot more power shots. But it's definitely fighting intelligently. When you got a guy like Ponce who can hurt you with one shot, you don't want to just rush in.
Ponce de Leon, the former 122-pound champion who successfully defended the title 6 times between 2005 and 2008.
All the fighters on this card coming in tonight had 206 knockouts, stoppages, that is. And so we've seen why in the first 2 fights already. We've seen 2 stoppages.
Gonzalez, the WBC featherweight champ, making his 5th title defense. Former WBO bantamweight champion.
And the crowd even seems to have dimmed down a little bit. There's no way they could have held the energy up either.
No, they're getting a little restier. And you know, it's not as if these guys aren't throwing punches. You see them, and they are picking, as you said, Paulie, they're starting to pick up the pace and to find the range.
Midway through round 2, Ponce de Leon flashes the jab, fighting out of the southpaw stance. Of course, the kryptonite for the southpaw is usually the right hand down the middle, and Gonzalez known for a vicious right hand, producing plenty of stoppages over the years.
And the other weapon that works so well is the left hook or double left hook to the body and the head. And Gonzalez, as I mentioned earlier, has scored knockouts with that punch.
Yes, he has, and he scored a nice right hand to the face of Ponce de Leon there. Final minute of the 2nd round. MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas, playing host to Knockout Kings Mauro Ranallo, along with Hall of Famer Al Bernstein and welterweight champion Holly Malignaggi, getting ready to defend his title in Brooklyn, New York. You're going home, Paulie, October 20th.
I'm coming home.
We got a song out of you. That's pretty good. Extra. You don't have to charge for that, is there?
No. Okay. Not for my voice, that's for sure.
Mark Anthony's listening.
And the spoiled fans here already a smattering of boos.
You talk about, imagine?
What have you done for me lately?
Sorry, they picked it up a little bit when the boos came.
Ponce de Leon moves Gonzalez back as we head to the 3rd round. And here's what's coming up on Showtime Sports. Showbox, the new generation, returns Friday, September 21st with 2 super bantamweight fights. On Saturday, October 20th, Showtime Championship Boxing comes to you from the new state-of-the-art Barclays Center in Brooklyn with another stacked lineup. A rematch between Danny Garcia and Eric Morales with the WBA and WBC light welterweight belts on the line. The aforementioned Paulie Malignaggi defending the WBA welterweight title against Pablo Cesar Cano, and Hassan Endam fights Peter Kid Chocolate Quillen for the WBO middleweight title. And don't forget, Saturday, November 10th, Abner Mattis squaring off with Anselmo Moreno for Mattis WBC Super Bantamweight Championship. All Showtime Championship Boxing events are preceded by the preliminary bouts on Show Extreme. The bell in round 3 for Johnny Gonzalez's WBC featherweight championship. The champion in black with silver. The challenger, Daniel Ponce de Leon, in black with green.
A clash of heads in that last round, and both men have small cuts because of it. I see the one cut on the forehead of Daniel Ponce de Leon.
Yeah, I think Gonzalez got a slight niggle right above his right eye.
Mm-hmm.
What happens when you're fighting a puncher, and both of these guys are punchers, you tend to have a little bit more respect when you're attacking or when you're picking your offense, you know. And it seems like both of these guys, although they want to fight and they're used to being in action-packed fights, they both respecting each other's power.
Yeah, you kind of expected that, especially for the beginning part of this fight.
And blood trickling down from that cut on the hairline of Ponce de Leon. Sorry, Al.
No, I'm sorry, Mauro. That was a good right hand by Gonzalez.
You know, no matter where the cut comes from, a lot of times if a fighter sees blood, it spurns him on to do more. Let's see if Gonzalez gets excited over seeing the blood on De Leon's face.
Right now, this fight has almost come down to, will Ponce de Leon land a big straight left that will hurt Gonzalez, or will Gonzalez land a right that will hurt Ponce de Leon? We're waiting to see which of those happens, if any.
Yeah, and you know what? Sometimes, even if it doesn't hurt them too bad, it may open up the floodgates for a brawl to break out, you know?
Yeah, good point. Both men are active. It's not as if they're not throwing. They're just not able to land as effectively as they'd like. Good right by Gonzalez, though.
Ponce de Leon now coming forward, him, right to the body by the champion as he wants to light that wick. And again, coming in, both of them have recorded spectacular knockouts in their career. Again, combining for 80 KOs. Ponce de Leon working the jab in the final minute. Catches Gonzalez with that left.
Gonzalez starting to find the range for that right hand. He's 5-3 in fights against lefties of note. He's fought over 10 lefties, but of lefties that are a higher echelon, he's 5-3. So he's had some success, but also some failures, as in against Nishioka, who knocked him out.
Gonzalez 8-3 in world championship fights with 7 wins by way of knockout.
Gonzalez had a pretty good round here.
Seconds left in the third round. This for Johnny Gonzalez's WBC Featherweight Championship. Ponce de Leon going over top with a left hand, then a straight left through the guard. Another left hand for Ponce de Leon, who's backing up as we go to round 4. And here in attendance at the MGM Grand, someone who thought he was going to be fighting in the main event, Victor Ortiz, the former WBC welterweight champion. And you have to wonder what is going through his mind after having his jaw broken by Josecito Lopez.
In a very close and competitive fight, when that jaw got broken, he just couldn't continue. He will certainly return, and he is an action fighter who's been in many action fights. It's a pretty bad gash, but it's in a spot where normally they would not stop this fight. Now we're heading into round 4. If they stopped it right now, it would be a no contest. However, if we get past the end of the 4th round, they would go to the scorecards if this fight was stopped.
And round 4 begins. WBC featherweight champion Johnny Gonzalez, the challenger Daniel Ponce de Leon. Ponce de Leon has 35 of his 43 wins by way of knockout. Sterling Southpaw fighting the orthodox champion, and there the Southpaw lands the left.
Sorry, that cut, although it's not in a bad spot on the scalp, it's in a place where the skin is just so thin, mm-hmm. and it's right up against the bone, right up against the skull, that the blood just trickles out. It's kind of frustrating because, you know, it's so high up, you wouldn't think it would get in Ponce's eyes, but it keeps leaking down.
It does, and that's a really good point, Paulie. Do you think a fight can be stopped with a cut at that point?
You know, again, you want to see how the fighter's reacting if he's fighting. I mean, Ponce seems like, you know, he's trying to make it like it's not bothering him. But the thing is, it's getting in his eye. I wouldn't want to stop a fight stop. But, I don't think Ponce does either. I mean, he's fighting. He's not even complaining or anything.
He's utilizing the ring and plenty of footwork here in round 4.
But it's so frustrating for it to get in your eye, even though the cut is so much above the eye.
Lands the jab. Does the challenger, Ponce de Leon, goes downstairs. And Gonzalez hits him with a right hand. A lot of respect between these two power punchers so far in this one.
Well, as we've said, they've both scored knockouts and been stopped. I mean, Gonzalez, when he fought against Nishioka, I've mentioned that fight, he had Nishioka down and hurt, but then he got knocked out. So he understands that it can go both ways.
But since losing to Nishioka and hooking up with the Hall of Fame trainer Beristain, he has reeled off 12 consecutive wins, 11 of them inside the distance.
Yeah, they're trying to box intelligently while throwing their power shots. But as you can see, anytime a guy throws his combinations, it's never more than two or three. They're looking to get in and get out. They don't want to stay in there too long inside the other guy's wheelhouse because they know the other guy can punch.
44 seconds left in the fourth round. Overhand left by the challenger. Gonzalez comes in, boxes the ears momentarily, and now Ponce de Leon sneaks a punch into the body. Seconds left in the fourth round. We are scheduled for 12 for the WBC Featherweight Championship. And blood again flowing, but it doesn't appear to be impairing Ponce de Leon's vision as Gonzalez lands the left hand. Ponce de Leon comes back with a left of his own, and round four's in the books. Well, it is a football season, and you know what that means. The fifth season of Inside the NFL on Showtime. Already a very compelling start to the NFL campaign.
A lot of big stories. Peyton Manning returning with an amazing performance. And the New York Jets scored not one, but a bunch of touchdowns. They haven't scored none in the preseason.
Yeah, all that controversy about that offense, and look how they came out firing.
Go figure. And meanwhile, the Bears lose to the Packers.
And a man who is looking to defend his title coming up in November here on Showtime. Amber Modest, WBC Super Bantamweight Champion. And we will definitely be looking forward to his title defense against Anselmo Moreno.
That's a great, great, great fight of two terrific champions coming together. And
yeah.
Kudos to that young man and Moreno for taking such a tough fight.
Yeah, everybody want to tune into that one. November 10th here on Showtime.
The bell in round five. The champion, Johnny Gonzalez, in the black with silver trunks. The challenger, Daniel Ponce de Leon, in the black with green trunks. Let's see if the pace begins to pick up here in the fifth frame.
Ponce de Leon has had mostly trouble with boxers. Yuriorkis Gamboa beat him. He lost to Adrian Broner in a decision that personally I thought de Leon should have won. But Broner, obviously, a bit of a boxer, more slick fighter.
Yeah, and Gonzalez obviously trying to follow that plan of boxing. He's in and he's out. He's not trying to sit there and trade with De Leon.
Very close fight, and these will be tough rounds to score.
Yeah, because the action, it comes in spurts.
Yep.
There's no action, and then there's suddenly a bunch of action. There's no action, and suddenly there's a bunch more. So you got to kind of pay attention and see what you like.
It's interesting. Johnny Gonzalez told us that he expected Daniel Ponce de Leon not to, jab and move. He expected him to brawl, and so far we've seen the opposite.
Yeah, you know, it's funny. De Leon seemed to come out a little bit aggressive, but as he started getting hit with a couple of pot shots and counters, now he's kind of mixed it up. He comes forward, he goes backwards.
Both of them employing the stick and move strategy, trying to work the angles. Gonzalez now comes in.
And Gonzalez now mixing in more left hooks to the body, which I think is a smart idea on his part. See, it's setting up the right hand now.
And he connected with that straight right. Ponce de Leon now wanting to deliver a left hand to the body and then a right hand upstairs.
And sometimes even if the body shots may not hurt the opponent, they may get blocked. What happens is you're varying the offense, you're varying where the punches are going, and the guy can't, a lot of times defense is anticipation. The guy can't anticipate where the punches are coming from.
Ponce de Leon really wanting to try to find the range, not quite finding it with his left hand. Left hook from the champion. Ponce de Leon with a 1-2 from the southpaw stance. Champ misses with a left uppercut. Last minute of the fifth round.
Johnny Gonzalez is keeping his hands up very well. Sometimes in fights he doesn't do that. And he's also counterpunching a little better now.
Left hook by the challenger, and another left tries to get through the guard. Ponce de Leon initiating the offense here in the fifth round with 31 seconds left.
Gonzalez has been very sharp, though, with a lot of his punches.
And he's done, like you say, Al, a great job of blocking with his guard.
Yep.
Although Ponce de Leon able to sneak a combination through in the final 10 seconds now of this fifth round. Again, a close encounter here for the WBC Featherweight Championship. Round six, straight ahead. Kenny Bayless saying, oh no, not again. Another punch there after the bell, but Ponce de Leon immediately said, mea culpa. Still to come tonight, the main event. One of Mexico's biggest stars, Canelo Alvarez, at just 22, looks to keep his perfect record intact. There is the one draw, but he'll defend the title against, well, the latest Rocky in boxing, that being Josecito Lopez, who is jumping up another weight class to try to pull off his second consecutive upset. Canelo versus Lopez, tonight's main event. And a huge crowd here in attendance at the MGM Grand Garden Arena. Over 14,000 in attendance. Mexican Independence Day weekend. And this crowd has been amped throughout the night. They've seen some terrific action thus far. And we are set now for the start of round six of this WBC Featherweight Championship.
In round five, Gonzalez landed 27 punches and Ponce de Leon 23. That's the most each man has landed in a round. And Gonzalez landed well over 50% of the punches he threw. So they're heating up a bit. Ponce de Leon managed by one of the best managers in boxing, Frank Espinoza. And Frank believes there's still plenty left in this fighter's career at age 32. And they think he can still get some big wins. Tonight's a very important fight, obviously, for him, as it is for Gonzalez in defending his title.
Minute gone here in the sixth round. And blood trickling from that cut on the top of Ponce de Leon's head from the accidental clash of heads early in the fight.
Kenny Bayless, the hardest working man in show business. Two fights in a row and two tough fights to officiate.
Ponce de Leon suffering the cut in round two. Nearing the midway point here of the sixth round. Straight right from the champion Gonzalez.
De Leon has a habit a lot of times when he throws in that left hand, he lunges in. Almeida alluded to it earlier, saying that he shouldn't lunge in. But another thing that he does when he lunges in, he's coming in with his head. And I think that's causing the risk for these head clashes.
That's a good point. You know, Gonzalez is getting sharper as this fight goes on, I think. You know, the crowd's a little restless about this fight. They're throwing a lot of punches. They're trying. They're just not as accurate as they'd like to be.
There's a straight left hand by the challenger. A left from the champion. There's a 1-2 combination that connects.
The bar was set pretty high in the first two fights.
Both ending inside the distance. Leo Santa Cruz, Marcos Maidana eligible for the $100,000 bonus for knockout of the night. The best knockout as chosen by the fans. It will be awarded at the end of tonight's telecast.
Those are some tough acts to follow.
De Leon has landed a couple of pretty good straight left hands. I don't know if that's enough to win him a close round. This round has been very close.
Final 20 seconds of the round. Referee Bayless calls for the break. Very methodical approach by both champion Gonzalez and challenger Ponce de Leon. Final 5 seconds. Ponce de Leon now coming forward, and oh! The champion goes through the ropes.
In a round, I thought Gonzalez was winning.
And it was ruled a knockdown. So, Ponce de Leon with a late knockdown here in the round.
Johnny Gonzalez came out looking good early in the round, landing this straight right hand, and the blood spurting from that cut on the top of Ponce de Leon's head. So as Paulie said, he was winning the round, but then trouble, Paulie.
Yeah, then he gets clipped here with a kind of a wild left hand. It seems he hooks it, hooks it out of the southpaw stance, which is a weird punch to throw, and obviously you don't expect it, and he definitely got hurt, and the follow-up drops him. Nice body shot on the follow-up, too, by de Leon.
Almost a catastrophe as he goes outside the ring. Luckily, he didn't injure himself.
Tonight's card also being broadcast in Espanol. Alejandro Luna and Israel Vasquez taking care of the Spanish commentary. Showtime.
Israel Vasquez, of course, in those great fights with Rafael Marquez.
Legendary.
Wow. I mean, great moments in boxing.
Three of Gonzalez's seven losses have come by way of knockout as we begin round seven of this WBC Featherweight Championship bout, scheduled for 12 rounds here at the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas. There's Ponce de Leon flashing the jab, follows up with the left.
If one of their common opponents, the most important one, Jerry Penaloso, who's a former champion, Johnny Gonzalez lost by TKO in round seven. Ponce de Leon won a decision. And that was in the same year, so you can judge them a little bit by that in some respects.
In some respects, he can now, but I remember that fight. Gonzalez was winning it handily, and then he got caught. I think it was a body shot.
And by the way, it's the same thing that happened when he fought Israel Vasquez, who we just saw. Gonzalez was winning that fight and got knocked out late in the fight.
A lot of those losses in his career, a lot like the last round. Round he was winning and he got caught.
Let's take a look at the unofficial scoring as done by our Showtime crew after six rounds.
Steve Farwood feeling Gonzalez is ahead. We've got Ponce de Leon by a little bit. And so it shows you this is a very close fight that could go either way. And those are close rounds to score.
Ponce de Leon goes to the body, then goes upstairs with the right, and Gonzalez doubled over. Ponce de Leon attacking the body again. Has to be careful to punch behind the head. Referee Bayless calls for the break. Now Ponce de Leon working the body, then going upstairs, backing up the champion. Ponce de Leon again working the body in the final minute now of the seventh round.
De Leon breaking him down. He's starting to break Gonzalez down.
He recorded the knockdown late in round six, and Paulie, you're right, beginning to wear down the champion. Gonzalez in his 60th professional bout tonight. A lot of wear and tear on this 31-year-old body.
A 13-year veteran, and you start to wonder if he could be shop-worn. We'll see, but he's coming back.
Ponce de Leon at the age of 32 in his 48th pro bout tonight. So two crafty veterans battling for the WBC Featherweight Championship.
All right, Mauro, thank you very much. Robert Diaz will translate for us. You were supposed to fight against Victor Ortiz, but Josecito Lopez beat him. Any chance now you're looking past Lopez?
Podrías haber estado peleando esta noche con Victor Ortiz, pero Victor le dio la sorpresa, le ganó Josecito López, y ahora habrá por posibilidad que estés viendo hacia un futuro y no a Josecito.
No, yo estoy listo para Josecito, no veo en el futuro, estoy preparado para él y no quiero distraerme en ningún o algo otro rival, estoy listo para Josecito.
Not at all. I'm concentrated, I'm focused, I'm prepared, and my mind is Josecito López, nobody else.
You saw him beat Ortiz. What concerns you most about López?
Lo viste ganarle a Ortiz. ¿Qué te preocupa más de López?
No, es un peleador que va para adelante. Es un peleador que tira muy buenos uppers, así que hay que estar listos en todo momento.
He's a fighter that comes forward, throws very variety of punches forward, aggressive, a lot of uppercuts. So we just got to be ready and, you know, take precaution.
Thank you for your time. Best of luck. We'll talk to you afterwards. Mauro, back outside to you.
Thanks a lot, Jim. Round eight of this WBC Featherweight Championship bout. The champion, Johnny Gonzalez. The challenger, Daniel Ponce de Leon. A close fight between these two veterans. And yet it seems in the last two rounds, Paulie, the challenger beginning to, as you mentioned, wear down the champ.
Yeah, De Leon's physicality seems like it's starting to bother Gonzalez. We got to see how in this last third of the fight if Gonzalez can make any adjustments.
And we talked about Gonzalez wearing down 117 punches thrown by Ponce de Leon in the last round to only 44 by Gonzalez. So a clear indication. And we look at the totals of the fight. It's very, very,
very close.
Yeah,
dead even.
Can't get much closer, but Ponce de Leon so much more active than Gonzalez. And so for a judge that doesn't have the wherewithal of the show stats, you know, those numbers thrown is going to make a big difference.
Ponce de Leon beginning to find a home for that straight left hand through Gonzalez's guard. Gonzalez then with a straight right through Ponce de Leon's guard.
And the only knockdown in this fight, of course, was of Gonzalez by Ponce de Leon, so that's a factor in the scoring.
Gonzalez went down and through the ropes at the end of round six following a flurry of punches from the challenger. Now Gonzalez putting together a combination, majority of which was blocked by Ponce de Leon, a little low, and they touch gloves as a sign of sportsmanship.
Gonzalez is starting to use the left hook a little more. I think that's going to have to be something he's going to have to mix into this arsenal a little more against Ponce de Leon. He lands it when he throws it.
Final minute of the eighth round.
Ponce de Leon actually slowed his pace a bit in this round in terms of number of punches thrown.
Even he needed a break, I think.
Yeah, he's been very busy.
Clash of heads.
And another accidental clash of heads as they batter each other like rams. And we've seen this time and again when you've got the southpaw against the orthodox fighter, and Johnny Gonzalez has a bad cut as a result of it here in round eight.
And remember, if it would be stopped now because of that, they would go to the scorecards.
James Game is the doctor who is now tending to the cut incurred by Gonzalez following the clash of heads.
Let me see your eye.
We look at where this happened. De Leon coming in, and you made the point earlier, Paulie, when he lunges in, that head, even if not unintentionally, becomes a weapon.
Yeah. I think in some ways he tries to protect himself from being countered, so he gets down real low to throw it.
And Gonzalez cannot see out of the right eye, and they are going to go to the scorecards for a technical decision. An unfortunate turn of events here in this WBC featherweight championship bout, but the accidental clash of heads has produced a truncated decision.
And it will be very intriguing, of course, this fight very close in terms of punches landed. Will it come down to that knockdown by Ponce de Leon in this fight?
Yeah, that's a good point, Al. A lot of these rounds were close. That's a two-point round for De Leon. And let's see. It'll be interesting to see these scorecards. On another note, this is the first fight of the night that will not be eligible for the knockout of the night.
You are correct, sir.
So in his fifth title defense, Johnny Gonzalez, the WBC featherweight champion, receiving a nasty gash over the right eye. The doctor tending to him, I guess, asked him he could see. He couldn't see out of the right eye, and we are going to the scorecards now. Three judges chosen by the Nevada State Athletic Commission will render their decision. So an anticlimactic finish to this championship bout.
And the fight was really heating up, and it's interesting because we could see it building.
Yeah, the fight was building. I think De Leon was starting to take the fight out of Gonzalez. And, you know, the fight ends up being stopped on that technical decision with the butt. You don't want to criticize Gonzalez. He's been a warrior his whole career, but it seemed like he was slowing down even before that headbutt, that head clash had happened.
Well, it's just a terrible cut. So, you know, they
they better, made that decision based on that.
Yeah, it's better to err on the side of caution with cuts like that, because besides the fact if you end up stopping it on, if you end up stopping it on later on the headbutt, you know, that cut could cost him rounds and he may lose it, and then you're scoring those rounds that the blood was in his face.
That's a terrific point. So it's the right decision and that right, fair to both fighters in a way. Yeah.
Daniel Ponce de Leon is a former WBO 122-pound champion who defended his title 6 times, now wanting to become the new WBC featherweight champion. Jimmy Lennon Jr. has the judge's decision. It's a technical decision. Let's go up to the classy one for the announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time of 2 minutes 36 seconds in round number 8. This bout has been stopped due to an accidental foul, according to the rules. At that point, we go to the scorecards with a technical decision. Here are the score totals. After these 8 rounds of action, the judges have the bout unanimous. Judge Jerry Roth sees it 77-74. Dick Houck and David Sutherland both score the bout 79-72. All 3 in favor of the winner by technical decision. He is the new WBC featherweight champion of the world, Daniel Ponce de Leon.
It may have not been the way any of us would have wanted to see it end, but Daniel Ponce de Leon, for the 2nd time in his career, is a world champion as he defeats Johnny Gonzalez to become the new WBC featherweight kingpin via technical decision, a unanimous one.
Unanimous and a little wider margin than I might have thought on one of the scorecards, but nevertheless, Ponce de Leon did a very good job here tonight and used his power to get this decision.
Yeah, he disrupted Gonzalez's timing. Gonzalez tried to box. I thought he had some early success, but de Leon disrupted him with the physicality, the awkwardness. My scorecard was the same as Jerry Roth, 77-74. In the end, I think de Leon got stronger while Gonzalez got weaker.
Clashes of heads was a theme in this fight. Early on, they would bang heads here. That one initiated a little more by Gonzalez, not intentional, but and that is where the cut, the blood started flowing from the top of the forehead of Ponce de Leon. Then what turned out to be important in this fight, the knockdown of Johnny Gonzalez. He had been hit with a big punch before this. Well, there, and then blasted into the ropes. Now, that didn't show the punch that started all this. That really made it a knockdown. And the fact of the matter is it was called a knockdown by Kenny Bayless. And it made that a 2-point round. And the last clash of heads, which created that awful cut over the eye of Johnny Gonzalez and caused the fight to be stopped. And right away, Gonzalez just was in huge pain from that. And a little anticlimactic, as we said in the ending, but this man wins another world title at age 32.
Gotta give De Leon credit. He got that cut very early, and it was leaking a lot. I mean, it was getting in his eye. It was coming down every single round. They couldn't stop it.
And as we look at the numbers, we see how close this fight was in terms of number of punches landed, but much busier Daniel Ponce de Leon, and that has an impact.
Yeah, it has an impact, and also mentally, it kept Gonzalez having to be busy, having to deal with pressure, and I think ultimately that wore him down.
All right, let's go to the judges' scores at the time of the stoppage.
Now, to the judges, Dick Houck and David Sutherland, with a wider margin than I would have expected. As Paulie said, he had a 77-74. That's a pretty wide margin, but, you know, they scored those close rounds for Gonzalez.
Well, and here's how the unofficial Showtime crew had it. Here's the unofficial Showtime scoring.
Very, you know, apparently Steve Farhood is the only one of the 3 of us who actually knows how to score. Steve Farhood, you added Gonzalez the other way. But no, you know, that's interesting. Why did you think Gonzalez was ahead?
Well, Al, you mentioned Ponce de Leon busier. I don't give points for fighters who miss punches.
Okay.
A lot of very close rounds, but Gonzalez was sticking, hitting De Leon on the end of his punches early, and I gave most of those early rounds to Gonzalez.
Okay.
The very close rounds.
Yeah, you know, it's a good point, Steve. A lot of tough rounds to score, a lot of ups and downs in terms of momentum where there would be action and there would be spurts of no action. I gave Gonzalez the first three rounds, and then I didn't give him another round the rest of the way.
And again, we look at the knockdown, which was a part of this, although the two judges that scored it for him would have still had him winning. There's that left hand that started the trouble for Gonzalez. Now, then when you look at the rest of it, was there another punch landed that pushed him? There was the body shot, and he ended up against the ropes. Kenny Bayless and felt that that body punch had probably pushed him against the ropes and created the knockdown.
He also had no legs, I think. His legs were still gone from the initial shot.
And Steve made a very good point about the scoring of this fight. Lots of close rounds.
All right, let's get it back to Brian Kenny.
Mauro, thank you so much. It is a raucous crowd. It's a packed house. And once again, our main event is on the way. Canelo Alvarez versus Jose Cito Lopez. This for Alvarez's WBC belt at 154 pounds. Now, the opponent tonight.